nature rich, delightfully off the radar, and teeming with historic and cultural remnants of ancient Japan. There are timeless treasures to be discovered in Tottori. Let us explore the birthplace of Japan together.
The world has finally opened up again, and as editor-in-chief of Metro Society, I take every opportunity to discover new places, meet new people, and explore different cultures. Join me in my journey to luxurious and meaningful experiences.
This is Raul Manzano, your EIC on the move.
This is Tottori, the least populated prefecture in Japan. It is rich in history, cultural significance, and natural resources. 14% of the total land area is made up of natural parks. This includes Tottori's most popular tourist attraction, the Tottori Sand Dunes in Sanin Kaigen Geopark, which is listed as a UNESCO Global Geopark. The Tottori Sand Dunes Visitor Center has exhibits and a visual mini theater, as well as information about the life in this harsh environment. This is where I'll be meeting my guide.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So I'm excited to check the sand dunes. This is the sand dunes here?
Yeah.
Yeah, wow.
It's a great day to explore the beautifully rugged coastline of Tottori, which features a rare gem of a destination in Japan, the Tottori Sakyu Sand Dunes. Crafted by nature and continuously reshaped by the wind, the site is a natural wonder and draws 1.3 million visitors each year.
I'm removing my shoes because I want to walk barefoot in the sand.
Down to the sea.
To the sea.
Sea. Yeah. Then washed by the waves.
Yeah, bring here. Yeah.
And blow up by the wind.
Yeah, by the wind. So that's why it's very high.
Yeah, the pile up like this much.
Right. So, yeah, easier to go up here.
Yes.
Yeah.
So we go
yeah,
this
we
way.
Go this way. Yeah.
So, how do you feel?
Nice, better with my feet than shoes.
So, in summertime.
Yeah, it's hot.
Very hot.
Very hot, so, okay. How come there's no sand in that mountain?
Looks close, but it's
yeah.
far.
Yeah, it's far, okay.
It's a spectacular feeling, walking here. I feel like I'm on the movie set of Dune, but I am not on another planet. I'm just in Japan, of all places. I honestly never thought that I would see sand dunes here, and watching the sand ripples form before my eyes is quite the thrill.
You can see the wind, look at
yeah.
the sand.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes.
You can see sand particle is
yeah.
moving.
Uh-huh. You can see it. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, wind ripple.
Yes, there, you can see the ripple.
Yeah, beautiful.
You can see the ripples. Wow. See, I can feel the sand particles on my feet.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for taking me around the sand dunes and for giving me a brief history of the area. Before I do anything else, I think I'm going to ride the camel and I'll explore the place by myself. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This isn't my first time on a camel, and these are not my first sand dunes, but it is my first time to be in what is called the birthplace of ancient Japan. and I want to learn more about the geology and the ecology of this special area.
Take me to museum. Thank you. Here we are at the Tottori Sand Museum, home to world-class sand sculptures only made possible by the convergence of highly experienced and skilled sand artists from around the world. Can you see the intricate details? I mean, the oasis at the back and these boats going down the Nile. The concept of the Sand Museum is traveling around the world in sand. And each year, a theme is chosen for a year-long exhibition. This year, it's Egypt. What a way to welcome me to Tottori, the sand dunes and the sand museum. I can't wait to see what else this prefecture has to offer.
Tottori may be Japan's least populated prefecture, but it certainly has plenty of places for locals and tourists to enjoy. And boutique hotels are able to curate more meaningful experiences with the help of Tottori's spectacular landscape.
Stunning settings, impeccable service, and an attention to detail are among the reasons why I enjoy staying in boutique hotels. Here at Auberge Tenku, where there are only 8 rooms in the entire property, I get to experience the best of luxury hospitality. Thank you so much. Thank you. Hi, thank you.
The name Auberge is French for a small inn or hotel, which is why the French interior design is very fitting in this boutique hotel.
What a nice room. So this is one of the rooms you can stay in at the Auberge. So they have a big king-size bed and a single bed. Very luxurious sofa. And this is what you are paying for, Mount Daisen. And you're at the foot. You can actually go out into your private bath and soak in the tub and look at that view, or hang out in their swing. And of course you have your tub here. Perfect. No, I would love staying in a place like this because it's private, it's far away from the city, and you know, you have your own private bath tent here. You don't have to share with anyone else. Welcome to my room. This is the newest room in the hotel property. What's good about it, it's separated from the main wing. So this is the living room. I think it's done in a French modern way. There's the fireplace, really nice furniture. And take note, this is the Japan Brand Collection 2024 Luxury Selection. And this hotel is part of it, Auberge Tenku. Okay, in this new annex, there's only one room here, but it's a large room, okay? It occupies a huge part of the garden. So let's go to the bathroom. This is the toilet. You can see the Japanese toilet. Then we have the two vanities with all the amenities here. And then we have the shower, which is a rain shower. And of course, the jacuzzi out here. Then coming out here, you have a beautiful garden with a beautiful view, and you have your own sauna. It's adorable. It looks like a hobbit house. I'll show you the bedroom now. Here it is. King size bed and a single bed all together. So this is basically for a family. And of course, the view again. But what a beautiful room. I mean, this is all just for me today. This is where I'm staying tonight.
Auberge Tenku is a French concept in a Japanese setting, and the combination of the two styles make for a stunning setting for a glamorous event or a relaxing stay in the Saihaku district of Tottori.
What a beautiful church against a magnificent background.
One can really work up an appetite in a calm and relaxing environment like this. So I'm off to Ristorante Tenku to take in the culinary experience that Auberge Hotel has to offer.
I'm here in Ristorante Tenku at Auberge Tenku, which can be found in the Michelin Guide. I am now looking forward to a wonderful 10-course dinner at the restaurant. Hi.
Hi.
Wow, this looks like a nice present.
Thank you.
Okay, so we shall unwrap. I'm very good at unboxing, okay? French flag. Here we go. Voila. The abalone is inside the container. Look at this. Oh, there's music. It's a musical box. So this is abalone with caviar and pâté de foie. You can taste the sea in this abalone plus the caviar. Perfect combination. It's so cool to eat out of a music box with music playing as you eat. So I am having now the Tottori Wagyu beef cheeks, okay? The cheeks, if cooked properly, is supposed to be the most tender part of the cow. The wine sauce is so good. You can actually look shredded because it's so cooked so well and so tender. So luxurious, okay? It's in a very nice red wine sauce. The cheeks are perfectly cooked. It's so tender, you can actually shred it with your fork. There, look at that. That's how tender it is. The cow has only two cheeks, okay? So it's very rare that you can get perfectly cooked beef cheeks. So here we have a shrimp and grouper carpaccio. It's drizzled with balsamic vinegar, so it's quite good. And the skin, you know, a lot of people don't eat the skin, but that's good for your skin. Fish skin is good for your skin. So, I'm having red snow crab with foam. You can see that they took the crowd meat up, look, and with tomato and cauliflower. And as you dig deeper, you find asparagus. Here you can see the roe of the crab, they included it. Best part of the crab is the roe. for my fifth course, I have steaming hot consommé. You know, consommé is very difficult to make. It has to go through about 10 straining sessions before you get the clearest broth. Thank you. Yeah. Beautiful dish.
Thank you.
So I'm having black throat sea perch with risotto and paired with a Chardonnay. Okay. The risotto is very creamy, okay, with mushrooms. Perfectly cooked risotto, still al dente. And the fish, flaky. Best dish so far. Okay, I'm more than halfway through. I think I have 4 more dishes. And I'm very impressed with the cooking here. Very good food. I am having a pear sorbet to cleanse my palate for the next courses that are coming. Very clean, and it really cleanses the palate. This being a pear sorbet, this because there's an abundance of pear here. They grow a lot of pears here in Tottori. It's put into a lot of their foods. So we have here a Tottori Wagyu teppanyaki with mushrooms. You see different kinds of mushrooms. And of course, the famous Tottori Wagyu. The kitchen here is an open kitchen. It's like a show kitchen. So when they cooked this steak, it was flambéed. You see all these flames coming out. And meat is cooked rare. It is paired with a Bordeaux. Red one, very good. So we are having a scampi pasta with tomato cream. This is my last savory dish. Looking forward to dessert. Just right, not overcooked because it doesn't stick to the skin. Looks like it's freshly made and it's the cream.
Okay. This is Milky Way.
Yeah, Milky Way, okay.
Hi.
Okay, so we have the Milky Way dessert, which is chestnut mousse and vanilla ice cream. Now we're going to have foam. Okay. Oh, wow. What a way to end my meal. Perfect dessert, cool weather today. Wow, I can't wait to check in tomorrow.
Tottori scenery is inspiring, and the prefecture takes pride in being able to take what's new while preserving what makes it traditionally beautiful. Surrounded by clean air and infinite green lands, and exposed to the pristine waters of Mount Daisen, Tottori's cattle lead a naturally luxurious life in a completely stress-free environment. The result is Tottori Wagyu. Our lunch today is the ultimate in culinary indulgence.
I'm looking forward to trying the Tottori Wagyu.
Takumi Kappou was established in 1962, and it maintains a very humble setup that puts focus on the star of the show, the beef. And according to the Michelin Guide, owner Shoya Yoshida is the creator of shabu-shabu. Tottori Wagyu Shabu-Shabu style, my senses are ready for a spectacular meal.
We are in Takumi Kappou to have a taste of Wagyu Shabu-Shabu style. This is the first restaurant to serve Shabu-Shabu in Tottori, and they use premium-grade Wagyu in their dishes. Look at this spread. The water is boiling, so I'm going to start cooking. Okay, I'll put, I like noodles. So I'm going to put some rib roast beef. Look at all that fat. And I'm going to put one sirloin, the number one Wagyu. They say that this Wagyu, the fat melts really fast. I'm dipping it in the sesame sauce. Of course, I'm going to put a little more chili oil. Okay. Wow. Beef melts like butter. So good. Wow. Totally melts in your mouth. Totally. Here we go. So the more meat you put inside, the more flavorful the broth becomes. And afterwards, we can drink this flavorful broth. Okay. Meat cooks quickly because it's sliced very thinly. Okay. They serve the food in traditional Japanese dishes, which they call minge. Normally, you just see these plates and serving dishes in museums. Here, you're actually eating out of them. So after that hearty meal, we cannot let this broth, this tasty broth, go to waste. So I ordered udon, throw it into the broth. So we will make it boil a bit. That tasty broth is going to be sucked up by the udon. Okay, this is going to be a little slippery, okay? So we put a little soy, leeks, a little Himalayan salt, some black pepper, and of course, togarashi. We shall now get some soup. So the udon noodles has taken in all the flavors of the broth. And I must say, this is a very good broth. So I'm going to try the broth, okay? It's so tasty. See, the broth has absorbed all the nutrients and all from that beef, and it's totally immersed in there. When one comes to Japan, one must eat Wagyu. Each prefecture has their own kind of Wagyu. Here in Tottori, it's a Tottori Wagyu, and here, you have to come to this original shabu shabu shop.
After devouring glorious Tottori Wagyu, I'm off to have some drinks. And instead of sake, I want to give locally brewed beer a shot. Serving local tables and bars since 1997, Daisen G Beer was born out of an assumption. If a prefecture has all the factors it needs to produce delicious sake, then it can very well make world-class beer. The experiment proved on point. Today, ask any serious beer drinker and they will tell you that Tottori's award-winning Daisen G Beer is top-notch. The beer is brewed at Bier Hot Gambaruis, which is located at the National Park of Mount Daisen. Hence, the name Daisen G Beer.
Hello.
Hello.
Nice to meet you. Okay. Yeah. Let's go see the brewery. Yeah.
The original brew house near the entrance began as a microbrewery and the company has since expanded its brewery to produce up to 4,000 liters per beer variant.
This is brew house. Okay.
The brew house, right?
Brew house.
Yeah.
This is another tank.
Okay.
Yeah.
So all the beer goes here.
Yeah.
Yes.
And about 1 month.
1 month here.
1 month here.
Fermentation.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
This is new brew house.
The brew house now. Yeah. This is new.
New.
Yes. Okay, so that's bigger. 2,000 liters. That one is 1,000.
1,000.
Okay, so that's bigger.
Double size.
So more beer.
More.
So. What kind of beer do you make?
Bite ten.
Bite ten beer. Yeah.
Wheat beer.
Yeah. Okay.
And Pilsner.
And Pilsner.
Yeah. Pale ale.
Oh, pale ale. Yes.
Stout.
Stout.
Dark ale.
Dark
ale. Is stout.
Okay, stout. Yes. Yeah.
Brewing day.
Ah, today. Perfect. Yeah. Let's go in.
Brewing is done in only one day, and we were lucky to visit on a brewing day. Fermentation takes up to 30 days, and Daisen G Beer can now produce up to 120,000 bottles in a year, half of which is delivered to Osaka and Tokyo for distribution.
So this is the bottle. It's bottled here, and this is Pilsner. So this is Biten beer. This is where it's brewed. It's 4,000 liters here of Biten beer. So Pilsner is brewed here at half the tank. It's 2,000 liters.
The facility is pretty big, and I honestly cannot imagine what this operation was like as a microbrewery. Small beginnings are always inspiring, and I'm pining to have a pint of the fruits of their labor.
Let's drink. Cheers.
Cheers. Wow. Good. Fresh. Hide-san, thank you so much for taking us on the tour and for making me try your beers in the restaurant. Yeah. Very good beer. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. So I'm here by the bar, and I'm going to taste two of the beers that they're brewing. Yeah. This is the Weizen. Yeah. So this is the Weizen. I'm going to taste it. It's creamy, but with a taste or a hint of bitterness, but very good. Oh, I like this beer. Let's taste another beer with a completely different profile, and I'm going to try the Dunkel. Ooh, look at all that froth. So this is a Dunkel. Wow, also good. So this is light in flavor, but dark in color. Look at how dark it is compared to the Weizen. So what would be my favorite? I like the darker color. I'd go for the Dunkel.
Whether it's locally made beer, brewed with high-technology machines, or Tottori Wagyu prepared in traditional shabu-shabu, Tottori is teaching me that it is in the preservation of the old and adaptation of the new that produces world-class products such as these. My belly and heart is full, and there is still a lot of Tottori for me to see and experience. From sand dunes and mountain views and an indulgence in excellent food and beer, I am retreating to a seaside resort to recharge my spirit with the help of therapeutic salt water and traditional Japanese hospitality.
I am now at Tottori's revitalizing Kaikei Onsen, a sprawling saltwater hot spring resort town right by the beautiful Miho Bay. Today, I will be doing thalassotherapy, which uses seawater as a form of therapy, of which Kaikei Onsen is known for.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much, so much.
The Kasuitei Hotel was established in the 1960s, and with over 70 rooms, tourists visiting the Kaikei Onsen are able to enhance their experience in this rejuvenating seaside attraction.
So we take off my shoes.
Yes, please take off your shoes here.
Okay. So this is a traditional Japanese room. Yes, tatami.
Yes, right? Tatami room.
Yes. So this is the living room.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
In this closet, in this Japanese-style room,
yes,
we got ready your
yukata. Yes. And this is the bedroom. So you have two twin beds here, and then you have a beautiful view.
Thank you.
Yes.
Scenery has been changed every day.
Yes.
Every day.
Yeah.
If it's clear, you can see Oki Islands. On the horizon.
On the horizon, yes,
yes. Next to that peninsula.
Yes. Very nice, the room.
Restroom.
This is, that's the toilet.
Toilet, yes. This is the bath.
Yeah. Oh, very nice. You have shower and bathtub.
Bathtub, yes. We got ready a lot of amenities here.
Yeah, plenty of amenities, no?
And the shampoo and the conditioner in the bathroom made from lavender.
The view here is spectacular and very relaxing. Now I'm looking forward to my treatment at the Kaikei Onsen. After my thalassotherapy at the aesthetic center, I am now here in my private onsen in my room, just relaxing. After having my bath in my private onsen in my ryokan, I tried the Sakyu shampoo, and boy, do I still smell it. And now, I am having a Kaiseki dinner in my room. What a treat. So I'm going to start with the pear juice. I guess it's there to cleanse your palate before you start eating all this food, okay? Wow, so good. You can see it's tofu with a tomato and I guess a salad dressing. And I have these five individual appetizers here. So let's try a bit of it. Oh, octopus. Salmon. So I'm saving myself for the Wagyu and the snow crab and the sashimi. Cool. Tuna. So fresh. Very fresh. Now I'll try. This is lobster. Very good. This is Tottori sake. I'm going to pour some. They say this goes very well with sashimi and sushi. So I'm going to pour some. Oh, very good. Perfect. I will now try the soup. Again, the Japanese use very little condiments because everything is so fresh. The broth is to die for. It's so clean, so clean. Mmm, so earthy. I'm going to try
snow crab. Look at the meat. Again, very fresh. You don't want to put anything to waste, so you try to get as much meat as you can. Okay, now for the pièce de résistance. Tottori Wagyu. I'm going to sear some. So as you can see, the marbling of the Tottori Wagyu. Perfect. All that fat. And then I'm cooking it in more fat, which is butter. Okay, we'll add a little salt. And I think this is some spicy sauce. Perfect cooking, my style. Rare. I like to dance when there's good food, like a friend, good friend of mine. Wow, it's so good. Tender, just a little bit of salt, and that miso sauce is just enhances the Tottori Wagyu. So I'm trying now the other sake. It's completely different from this. This you can, it's quite fruity, you can taste the fruits. It's layered with different kinds of fruits. That's so good. I'm enjoying my stay here at Kasuitei. I had more than my share of vitamin SEA here in the Sand Dune area of Tottori. Kasuitei Hotel's private onsens is the height of luxury. It is no wonder that locals and tourists treasure this sanctuary. And I am forever grateful to have had this chance to be renewed by the sea here in Tottori, Japan.
Every time I visit a new prefecture in Japan, I always try their local ramen. Tottori is known for their gyukotsu ramen, which uses broth taken from beef bones, lending it a rich, meaty flavor. And I'm excited to try it. So what I ordered is their signature ramen, and it's very popular with the locals here. As you can see, I'm ready with both hands.
Wow. The broth is excellent.
And they order the noodles to specifically fit what's being served with the soup. Since I like mine spicy, I'm going to put some togarashi. Not some, a lot. And chili oil. So, the broth is very good as it is, but I just like to enhance it with a little bit of spice. That's why I put a lot of togarashi. The beef was brought almost raw here, and they make the broth will eventually cook it. See, it's cooked already, look. They also add some mung bean sprouts. Wow, this is so good. I get why this is a signature dish. I mean, the broth is perfect. The noodles go very well with the beef and the other vegetables that come with it. But I heard there's a spicier one, so I also ordered that. Yes. See that smile on my face? It's the spicy ramen. Even the color, it's red. Okay, let's see how spicy it is. Very good, but still not as spicy as I want. This is spicier than any of the other ramens I've tried, but still not to my level. But I can eat a bowl of this every day. Despite all the spices here, the bone broth, you can still taste the flavor of the bone broth. You can tell that this broth was made with care, and it was boiling for a long, long time. So good. So, the ramen master thinks that I don't find it spicy, so he gave me a special blend, and I shall pour it into the noodles. Let's go for it. Now I'm feeling the heat in my body. But it's still not spicy for me, okay? It's just going through my system. Now I understand why the locals like ramen go cold. Food's good, the soup is out of this world, and the ramen master is one of the best. When in Tottori, it is definitely a must to stop and smell the flowers. Here at Tottori Hanakairo Flower Park, lilies of 15 varieties bloom almost all year round. The Tottori Hanakairo Flower Park, located in the Saihaku district of Tottori, is famous for its moonlight flower garden, where the glow of tens of thousands of flowers across 50 hectares, the largest in Japan, makes for an amazing spectacle. This is every flower lover's dream come true. Rain or shine, flowers are in bloom. Right now, 15 lilies are in bloom inside this little building. Even when it's rainy, you can go to certain buildings and there are flowers. Any time of the year, every season, the flowers change. This building is so packed with flowers, the smell hits you the moment you come in. It is truly a special experience to be in this flower park. The sight of so many flowers and the embrace of their scents brings me to a level of happiness that I cannot describe. The pleasant engagement with my senses is about to increase because inside the Tottori Hanakairo Flower Park, the same flowers will be served with excellent dishes at the restaurant. Okay, it's quite interesting that the food that they serve in this restaurant contains some of the flowers that they grow here. So this is interesting. So this is shirashi zuji that I'll be eating today. Okay, let's try it. Okay, I'm going to get, there's the flower with more flowers underneath. So the flowers add another texture, and it does enhance the flavor of the shirashi sushi. Very good, very good. It's actually a little spicy, huh? Maybe because of the flowers they put. I think in Manila, this is called the gumamela. So here I'm eating it. The first one, the yellow one, was a little bit more thicker. The last flower I ate was much finer. Now this one, very different, very different. I mean, this one's bitter, very bitter. Let's try this. This is a little tough, okay? But it's good. Very good. So this has been a different kind of lunch, okay? It's visually, it's beautiful to see. Actually, these are the flowers that you saw as you walked around the flower park. And now you're actually eating it. You're eating what they grow. The food's very good. And the flowers do taste very different. It enhances also the shirashi sushi. So very, very good. So this has been a different kind of experience. So I shall continue eating.
Sand dunes may be what makes Tottori popular, but after my visit, I realized there is more to Japan's least populated prefecture. From its divine Wagyu to its revitalizing hot springs, Tottori has not only left me surprised, but excited for a future visit.
This is Raul Manzano, your EIC on the move.